What's going on, people? We are going to be doing an unboxing and overview video. You already know what it is from the title of the video and the thumbnail on the vid, so roll the package in here. I got the ship Priority, and it came damn fast. So, I'll just cut it right down here, using the Spyderco Military. I know people love to know when I'm cutting stuff open. I'm trying to do this kind of precision-like, because I do want to save this box. Oops. There we go. Now, it should come open. Right here. That was actually easier than I thought. Okay. Packaged in there. Yeah, I like to save these smaller boxes. They come in handy. And I guess it's packaged in here somehow. Oh, there we go. Okay, and there we are. Look at that. Emerson knives. Back there, or on the side rather, UBR Commander. You're definitely going to be saving this box. Open that up here. Pull it up. Holy frig. Wow. Before we get into the knife, let's see what else we got in here. Sticker and looks like just some product literature. I'm going to get that out of the way real quick. Focus on. Holy crap. This is quite a bit bigger than I thought it was going to be. Look at that. Let's get this open here. Holy frig. Emerson UBR Commander. Let's get a close-up of the blade there. It is in this stonewash finish there. It doesn't say what steel this is, but this is 154 cm. At least it doesn't say. No, it doesn't say on that side either. I've heard that Emerson doesn't put that on its blades, and I guess it's true. 154 cm steel, which is basically the same as ATS-34. There's debate as to whether or not they are different or indeed the same. I think it just comes down to the heat treat. There's very grippy G10 scales on here. It is a liner lock. You can see right there. I don't want to cut my finger off here. I like the thumb stud. A wave function here. Nice pocket clip tip up only, obviously. Let's get a size comparison between it and the Military. Okay, here's a Spyderco Military. Let's put that down there. And then, yeah, the Commander actually kind of dwarfs the Military. It doesn't feel much heavier, though. I mean, it is obviously heavier, but this is my first Emerson. I've never owned an Emerson before in my life. Jimping on the back's a little bit slippery. I notice it's got jimping here, too. I'm not sure what that's for. Man, this thing is a beast. Look at the size, like here. Look at the size of this knife. Thing is just huge. I'm pretty impressed. Do a little thumbnail test. Yeah, it's sharp. Look at that. That is a thing of beauty right there. Emerson UBR Commander. I'm going to carry it for a while, see how it works, and maybe in the future do an update video, but as it stands right now, I mean, this is bigger than a lot of fixed blades I own. Really comfortable in the hand, too. I really like that thumb stud, or thumb disc, I should say, they call it. Oh man, I'm just blown away at how big this thing is. That's crazy. Alright guys, Emerson UBR Commander, 154 cm blade steel. Get one if you can. If you're interested anyway. They make others in the Commander series. Maybe some smaller offerings. This thing is friggin' huge. This is definitely the largest folding knife that I currently own. I don't think I've ever owned one larger than this. Actually, I'm certain that I haven't. I used to own those zero tolerance what do you call them, 0300s, I think they're called, and I don't think they were even this big. They were a lot heavier, I can tell you that. This actually doesn't have a lot of weight to it, but, man, that is, it's an awesome knife. All right, guys, check you later.